guys. Today we are playing with some toys from my bathtub. We are going to learn about a few things today that are really cool in addition and subtraction. We will use some of my toys to help us. Let's take a look. Here are some ducks. We have 3 blue ducks and 7 yellow ducks. Can you tell me how many ducks we have in all? We have 10 ducks altogether. When you add 3 and 7, you get 10 ducks in all. Now here is something really cool. The ducks just moved positions. Is the answer still the same? Yes, the answer is still 10, the same as before. In addition, we have what we call the commutative property. This seems like something difficult to understand, but it is not. All it means is that when we are adding numbers together, they can be switched around as much as you want, and the answer will still be the same. This only works for addition, so remember that. Here is a math problem where we can use what we just learned. It says if 8 plus 2 equals 10, then blank plus 8 equals 10. We need to fill in the blank with the missing number. We know that 8 plus 2 equals 10. We just learned that in addition we can switch the 8 and 2 around and still get the same answer of 10. So to fill in the missing number, what do you think it will be? The missing number is 2. The numbers 8 and 2 were just switched. With the 2 in the blank, we get 2 plus 8 equals 10, and that is true. Great job, kids! Here is another math problem, but this time it is subtraction. The problem says, if 9 subtract 4 equals 5, then 9 subtract 5 equals blank. We need to fill in the blank. The first thing we should know is that subtraction is not the same as addition. In addition, we can switch the numbers around, but not with subtraction. But addition and subtraction are similar in some ways. Let me show you what I mean. Here is a math mountain. If you are not familiar with a math mountain, that is just fine. At the top, we have the total. At the bottom, we have what we call partners or addends. The total is 9 and the partners are 4 and 5. We can use both subtraction and addition with this math mountain. If we add the 4 and 5 together, we get the total of 9. We can also subtract. Just like the first part of the problem below, 9 subtract 4 equals 5. Let's solve the part of the problem we don't know. 9 subtract 5 equals what? You probably figured it out, but let's use addition to find the answer. We will start at the partner we know, which is 5. Let's count up from 5 until we get to the total. Starting from 5, we count 6, 7, 8, 9. We counted 4 numbers, so the other partner is 4. Amazing job! I'm sure you can now see that subtraction and addition are related. I want to show you one last addition skill. The problem says 2 plus 6 plus 4 equals 12 is the same as 10 plus blank equals 12. When we are doing addition with more than two numbers like this, it is helpful to make groups of doubles or tens. In this example, we can combine the 6 and the 4 together to make 10. Adding with 10 is much easier than trying to add 2 plus 6 plus 4. Many of you already know partners of 10, like 6 and 4, 5 and 5, 3 and 7, and so on. Now we just have to add 2 plus 10, which is 12. It saves us time to combine numbers that make 10 and then add the other numbers. So the blank in this problem should be filled with what number? The answer is 2. 10 plus 2 equals 12. Great job again! That was a long lesson, but it will help you as you add and subtract. Thanks for coming. We will see you next time.
You have a few options here. You can click the video on my right or on my left to watch more awesome stuff. If you want to subscribe, click the big red subscribe button below. You might want to hurry and choose though, because I can't hold on forever. Hurry, choose. Uh-oh.